NFL on EA Sports, and we are at Highmark Stadium in upstate New York.
Coming up, we've got what should prove to be a good one between the Arizona Cardinals and the Buffalo Bills.
And we are underway in Buffalo. Fields this way up at the 17. And he'll get it up just past the 20 as his guys will go to work at the 21-yard line. First carry for James Conner. They'll get this to the 24, and it's second down.
Well, from an offensive perspective, that was a tough run because he only picked up 3 yards. But let's flip it over to the defensive side. They now have the advantage. Three-yard gains, that means they're punting the ball likely on fourth down. That's what you're looking
for. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Micah Hyde. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line. So CD, his very first pass of the afternoon, intercepted.
And I know that's a major surprise for any quarterback because, look, let's face it, no one thinks about throwing interceptions. But think about all the warm-up that we saw, right? Every pass he threw wasn't a single interception because, oh, that's right, there were no defenders out there. A little bit different when there's live guys out there chasing the football.
They'll toss this right side to Singletary. Room here to run. And he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10. 23 yards on the pickup there and a first. Right when he pitched that to him, it looked like he had a good numbers advantage on the outside. He did, and it turned into a nice game.
Allowed his vision to take over, too, because he was able to pick when he put his foot in the ground and took off upfield because he actually had options. Could he go now, wait another second? It really didn't matter, but he chose the exact right time and turned it into a big-time run.
The last run good for two. Here's second and 8. Singletary again. And he is going to lose yardage here. A yard in the wrong direction makes third down tougher. Third down and 9.
And that's exactly what you're looking for at the inside linebacker spot. Versatility. He can drop into coverage, or as he did on that last play, use his speed to get to the perimeter. And
touchdown, Bills! Allen on target there to Stephon Diggs. And the Bills use the early turnover to get on the board first here in this one. Charles, here in their opening series, they said they had certain plays scripted for certain players. That looked like a well-designed play to get one of their top targets involved.
Yeah, let's face it, Brandon. A player of his talent is a problem for any opponent to defend, and we saw it right there. They tried to deny an open lane to him. He still outplayed the coverage and scored the early touchdown. Good luck trying to figure out how to defend him as this game moves on.
He hits the big target for the 2-point try. Defenses hate those guys, especially around the goal line.
It's hard to decide who you're going to put on him. Are you going to put a smaller corner on him? Are you going to put a safety who doesn't have maybe the same coverage skills? How about a linebacker? He may have the size, but he's not used to really covering in space. That's why the tight end gives you such a great advantage when you're throwing the football.
Ready to go with their next drive and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And the interception on that opening drive winds up leading to the touchdown, so now it's kind of time to start over.
Yeah, it certainly is, and his first throw of the game. But I like the way his guys rallied around him. Oftentimes, the quarterback is the leader, right? He tells everyone what to do. In this case, I notice his linemen around him kind of patting him, saying, "Let's go, big boy. You're still our leader."
Now the pass, and it's into the arms of Hopkins. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. First catch of the game for Hopkins. It's a first down.
Well, I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere, and they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well, and that's what they just did on that play.
First down, Murray.
DeAndre Hopkins making the catch. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
And that's how you shake off the interception you threw on the opening drive, come back and throw another strike and gain nice yardage. And I give credit to two people on this one. The man throwing the ball and the person calling the plays. They're not
trying to force it to Hopkins, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Micah Hyde. And the Bills are going to take over here on the INT at their own 5-yard line. And I saw the pressure coming out, and that just looked problematic. Hit him as he threw it, and the interception ensued.
Let me pay homage to the man who stood in this spot before. He always talked about how much pressure is in the face of a guy, and can he step into a throw? And when you can't do that, oftentimes interceptions result.
Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's second and two. Allen now looks to throw. And this is intercepted. He was trying to get it to Davis. Picked up by Marco Wilson. And he is going to bring this back inside the 20 to the 18-yard line. And they'll take possession already in the red zone and in a great spot to add points to the scoreboard.
And Brandon, how many times have we seen a defense with a lot of field behind them get even more aggressive, right? They feel like they've got them not pinned down, but in a favorable spot for them, and they took advantage of it there. Got a nice interception and set up their offense in great shape.
A solid pickup of 13 sets him up first and goal.
How about the way they're moving the ball down the field? They had a big play a moment ago, followed it up with another nice one here, and before you know it, they're already looking at first and goal.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Cardinals. Zach Ertz from 6 yards away. And the Cardinals have come back to make it a 2-point game. Oh, and now they're going to fake it. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Okay, they went for the fake off of the extra point attempt. It's a long way to go, and they didn't get there. Didn't get it completed successfully. Did someone dare them to do that? Did someone double dog dare him to do that?
Maybe they saw something on film, but do you see something on film to try something from the 15 on a PAT? I don't know.
The only thing they needed to see on film there was a snap, a hold, and someone kicking the ball through the post.
Buffalo offense ready to go for their next drive. And we'll see if they can bounce back from that last drive. In particular, if they can bounce back at the quarterback position, Charles, after throwing their first interception of the ball game.
Yeah, some guys, you know, they're going to want to try and get a big play right away and take control back. Others, they're going to want to look to hit a couple shorter passes, get a little momentum back that way.
But for the defense, that goal's not changing a bit. They want another pick.
You're exactly right about that. In fact, you've got to watch them a little bit because in coverage, they may cut down their gaps a little bit, maybe their splits a little bit, in order to try and get to the ball even faster.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. On the handoff, running left, Singletary. They'll get this down to the 38. The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. A give up the middle to Singletary. 82 yards rushing for him as he has been tough to stop here this first half. They'll give this to Singletary running right. And he'll get it down inside the 20 to the 18-yard line. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3. Singletary trying the left side. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. They'll need 5 on this play to move the sticks. Here's Allen. Works right side into the hands of the tight end, Knox. Touchdown! Dawson Knox, a touchdown grab from Josh Allen. And the Bills are in for 6.
On that 3rd down call, the goal was to get the ball to their tight end and pick up a 1st down, but he wasn't satisfied with just that. They got the first down. That was the gravy. He decided to take in the whole meal and rumbled in for a touchdown.
And this is going to be caught. It's good. And that extends their lead by two more. Here's the Bills kickoff unit out as they will send this one away. And a short kick taken at about the 16. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 30, right about the 29. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. A strong showing their last time out. They scored the touchdown, but Charles, they look up and they're still down double digits, so you feel like just to keep pace, this drive probably needs to end in the end zone as well.
Yeah, and I think the best move for them is to not worry about how far they are down on the scoreboard, but to just remember the last drive and how it ended. Go ahead and try and repeat that. Then you can look at the scoreboard and see where this game is.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
Murray now on first down. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Jair Elam makes a pick, and they'll set up shop in enemy territory at the 45-yard line.
And that's a great example of ball skills right there, partner. You and I do a lot of games, and I can't tell you how many guys look to run with the football before they've intercepted it. So that's a nice job of focusing on the task at hand and coming away with the interception.
On the ground, it's Singletary. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine. On the give, this is Singletary. They follow up the first down 1 yard run with a minimal gain of two. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
And we've hit the 2 minute mark in this first half of action. And they'll need to get to the 35 if they want to keep this drive going on third down. A give, Singletary right side, and he gets this only to the 41, not near enough for the first. Allen will look to throw for it on fourth. That's caught by Gabriel Davis, and he is going to have the Bills' first down as they manage to convert, and that'll keep the drive alive. It goes as a pickup of 23. And it's first down, Buffalo.
And that's a big pickup on the first down. And you know that all week, both sides of the ball, offense and defense, are going through every situation. And in this case, the offensive guys had the right play dialed up, because defensively, you work on fourth down situations as well.
And deflating for the defense. They can't get the stop here. 6 yards on that last play. Here's second and four. And he's dropped just before the line to gain. 4 yard pickup leaves him with third and one. On third down, they go with Singletary. Oh, they hit him in the backfield, and he will not escape. And that is not going to get it done. Losing 2 yards that time, and now it's fourth down. Now the Bills are going to use the first of their timeouts as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this first half. So they're going for it, and here's Allen. That's complete, right around the 8. Touchdown, Bills! Dawson Knox, a touchdown grab from Josh Allen, and the Bills will extend their lead in the final minute of the half. They'll look to throw toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. The third time wasn't a charm. They got the first two-point tries. Still have the lead, but couldn't get the third.
Okay, so they didn't get this one, but I have to ask you, what matchup are they seeing that they feel that confident to go for two so often?
And he can't field it cleanly. It's loose. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Yeah. ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
The big play to start him out has him at the 45 already. Right back to Connor here on first. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game. Now the Cards going to call another timeout, their second, as they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half. On second and very short, Murray. And incomplete on the deep ball. They only needed a few inches there on second, but forget the halfback dive. They were going for the big one.
I thought it was a good time to take a shot. You figure with their running game, if they don't get it there, you come back and run for it and pick up the first down. Go ahead and be aggressive and try and get one downfield for a big one.
Looking for Hopkins, and he's got him on the crossing route. And the timeout comes in with 2 seconds remaining. So they can trot out the field goal unit for the try before we hit the lockers. So with 2 ticks left here in the half, on is the field goal unit. This from 36 yards out. Prater's kick is good, and that will do it for this first half. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports.
Final adjustments being made for the second half. So with that, we get you back up to Orchard Park and rejoin Brandon and Charles.
Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number 3. Bills with the lead, and they'll get the football first as the second half is underway. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. Charles, for them, pretty good first half on the ground. They had some success running the ball in quarters 1 and 2, and they've got the lead now, a chance to expand upon that lead here with their first drive in the third quarter.
Yeah, believe it or not, you and I have noticed that this great game of football has shifted towards pass first, run second. So for me, it's really nice to see some of these teams keeping the ground game as a big component of their offense, and it's working pretty well for them now. And let's face it, they can continue to do damage with it. And in addition, it sets up the pass game really well for them, too.
It'll be a loss of a yard, and that's going to lead to a 3rd and 4 coming up.
And plays like that are exactly what this defense needs here early in the second half to give it a little spark. I think their halftime adjustments, what they talked about, maybe just a little inspirational speech. Who knows? But looks like they're ready to go.
And some space here. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. 127 yards for him on the ground now, as he has been terrific here this afternoon. So into Cardinal territory now. It's 1st and 10 at the 47. They go right back to Singletary. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be 2nd and 8.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
On second down, here's a run with Singletary. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. Officially, no gain on the play, and they're left with a 3rd and 8. They'll be in search of 8 yards here as they hope to convert the first down. Allen going to throw. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up.
From a defensive perspective, they had exactly what you want anytime they want to throw the football. There was pressure on the quarterback. They were getting after him, and they tightened down on the receivers and forced the incompletion.
Allen going to go on fourth down. Looking for Diggs, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Marco Wilson. And the Cards are going to have great field position here as this is returned just shy of midfield. That is just what this defense was hoping for, an interception on the opening possession of this third quarter.
Obviously didn't want to surrender a touchdown and fall even farther behind. And we've gotten to know this team a little bit, haven't we? Couldn't you just see their defensive leaders telling the offensive guys, telling the quarterback, don't worry, we got you to start things off. You take it from there.
Ready to go with their next drive and at the line, the Cardinal offense. They start near midfield following the interception as they begin first and 10. After the turnover, here's Murray. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Tre'Davious White with a pick. And the Bills will take over here just shy of the 30.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively, getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where's he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
Allen and the Bills now with a first and 10, just shy of the 30. He'll give it to Singletary here to start the drive. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
Not a lot of running room there, not a place to make a cut and kind of exit out because they had everything bottled up. Looked to me like the linemen were taking on their blocks really well and giving up no creases.
Right back to Singletary on second down. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 10 yards, good enough for a Buffalo first down.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
They run on first down, but it only produces a gain of 2. It's second down now. And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Second and 8. Allen going to give this one to Singletary, and he stopped immediately there. This offense on third down today, they've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This is 3rd and 8. Pass delivered successfully to Knox on the out route. And he goes out of bounds. It looks like right at the 50. He'll go down as a gain of 6, and that's going to bring up a 4th down.
Now that's going to be a tough one to explain when they get together to watch the game film, isn't it? I mean, they had the right call, had the out route. He's got to know where the first down sticks are, yet he steps out of bounds that close. Not their best play.
Now Allen throwing on 4th down. That's caught by the big tight end, O.J. Howard. He's got the first down and more than that. And all the way home for a Bills touchdown. Pretty impressive, Charles. It's one thing to be an elite speed wide receiver and have all that yards after the catch into the end zone from your tight end.
Yeah, you don't get that very often. What you're describing is more like a Tyreek Hill, a Davante Adams, and Antonio Brown. You're not talking about a guy that lines up or can line up in line and look like an extra tackle on running plays. He took that bad boy downfield just like he was a scat back.
Before the game, he told me, I'm going to have a zinger or two today. And I was like, oh, a zinger or two? I guess that's a zinger, right?
That's a zinger.
A fairly short kick from the 14. And a nice job there on special teams to limit him to inside the 15 as he's dropped at the 14.
in this position, trying to get back into the game. Teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try and put points on the board.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. Where we stand right now in the fourth quarter, this one pretty much out of reach. And, Charles, I know they're good. And, my goodness, another interception. Teron Johnson able to pick it. And he is going to score. It's a pick six and a Bills touchdown. Well, just to add that to the list of great moments for this defense today, they've really shredded that game plan on the other side all four quarters. And, Charles, that pick six, that's kind of the cherry on top.
Yeah, they did it, and I feel like I'm quoting a bad movie line, but they did it together, didn't they? Fed off of each other, every big play they made, every tackle, every pick, everything they've done. They continually built energy in this one, and how about them culminating with a pick six?
And a short kick taken at about the 16. And he takes this near the 25, just a little pass there, called it the 26. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And you can sort of sense their dejection. That last pick six put the icing on the cake, so to speak, in what has been a rough go for them. Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete.
They lead big, and a major part of that has been how they've taken their play to a whole new level this second half. No points allowed since the break, and you can add another incompletion to the total number that they forced in this runaway contest.
And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. He had the touchdown earlier. This one's going to get him a first down.
Well, this game was decided a while ago, and that completion there is going to artificially inflate his passing numbers. So right now, the only one really applauding probably his agent as he thinks about angling for a new contract.
And now here is another interception. Picked off by Micah Hyde, and they will set up shop in enemy territory at the 42-yard line. Yes, folks, that is his third interception, and I'm going to use one of the most overused phrases in football. He's a ball-hawking safety.
I love the way that you called for the shot there. That's perfect, though, because there is something to that. Being a safety often allows you freedom to roam around a defense, maybe not a specific assignment. Today, his assignment, find the football, and he's done so quite well.
But now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. But their passing attack, even though that one was incomplete, has been really sharp in this one. It's resulted in a lot of touchdowns, and it looks like they're not going to stop throwing the football until the very end of this one.
Well, that will certainly make everyone involved on offense pretty happy, because that gives them all a chance to pad their stats a bit. But as far as the actual need, you and I both know they can just run this clock out, because this one, it was over a long time ago.
Throwing now is Allen. Going deep for Diggs. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
I think it's fairly safe to call this game over, but they're still trying to bomb it downfield and add to their lead. Almost makes you start to feel for the defense and root for them a little bit, too.
On fourth down, Allen. And bringing it in, it's Davis. And he is going to have the Bills first down as they manage to convert. And that'll keep the drive alive. And this will probably be the final play before the two-minute warning. They'll run on first down with Singletary. And he'll get this forward only for about a yard, as that's going to take us to the two-minute warning. Right back to Singletary on second down. And he'll get this one down to about the 17. Seventh play of the drive upcoming here on third and six. To the air, Allen. And he's going to be intercepted for the third time thus far. Buda Baker with a pick.
And a huge return as he'll take this one all the way down inside the 30-yard line.
I tell you what, credit is due there on them preventing the touchdown after that interception.
How about him chasing him down and not giving up the pick six? Because what happens a lot of the time is when you see the interception, you just kind of hang your head a little bit and you momentarily pause because you're frustrated. He shook that off and gave great chase and got it done.
Still a great return and very good field position. Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. To throw is Murray. That pass complete to Moore. And he'll be marked down at about the 26-yard line. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. You tackle them almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
Now the throw on third down, knocked away and incomplete.
As a defensive back, you have some weapons at your disposal that we don't often talk about. And you can read the receiver's eyes, you can read his hands, and you know that the arrival of the ball is imminent. And that allows you to make a play on it and oftentimes knock it away.
Now Murray's got to have this one. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and the Bills are going to get the football back. So they tried to go for it for pride, but it really wouldn't have mattered. This one, it was already determined.
No doubt about it. This one was over a while ago.
Buffalo offense ready to go for their next drive. Now they are really in the driver's seat here, enjoying this lead late in the fourth quarter. The defense does have all three timeouts, but at this point, doesn't look like it's going to matter much. The Cardinals going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the game.
Partner, I have to tell you, just one word keeps coming to mind from watching them this afternoon, and that's impressive. They have been impressive from the opening kickoff, and they haven't let up here even into the fourth quarter.
Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete. The CD, they're up big, but they're still passing it. I mean, this is an offense that's had a lot of success in this game, and it seems like they're just having fun out there.
And it does feel like there's been a shift out there, doesn't it, partner? Listen, if you're up, you can continue to do what you want to do. It's up to the other team to make you change how you do things. They'll continue to throw it around until stopped.
So Allen's going to look to throw. He's got the hookup with Diggs. And what are the whistles for? Timeout. So they'll stop the clock here in a game that's been decided in the closing seconds. Allen to throw once more. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
Well, they're up comfortably here, Charles, but that lead certainly not dissuading them from pressing the envelope late. I mean, if anything, with these passes, it's like they're getting more aggressive to try to drive the ball downfield.
And that will certainly...
And this will be caught. And the carnage continues. It's another touchdown.
Well, this is long since over, and some might see this as overkill. But remember, this is a team that puts on the hard hats, grabs the lunch pail, and tells everyone, we're going to give you a full 60 minutes. And that's exactly how they're playing this one out.
Will try to throw for it, and this is going to be caught. So add two more to the lead as they continue to pour it on here in the fourth. And they've got it. They recovered it. But hang on now, though. There's a penalty flag down.
Yeah, you got to wait until that ball goes 10 yards. They did not. They hit it before, and that draws the flag every time.
And there's no doubt in my mind that converting an onside kick has never been tougher in the NFL with the new rules. So trying to get it to 10 yards, timing up perfectly, that's tough enough to begin with. But when you go ahead and grab it before it goes, you've got no shot then.
Murray, one final try. Going deep for Hopkins. And this is dropped and incomplete.
Yeah.
Well, there's a metaphor for how this one is gone. As time has run out on this ball game.
And as this defense walks off the field, they can do so with their heads held high. What a performance by the offense, too. I mean, really, Charles, just complete domination on both sides of the football here in this one.
Certainly was, and I think both sides compete against each other all the time. You go to each other in practice, obviously your training camps, your offseason. But on game day, you both want to show your best. And I think that's what we saw for both the offense and the defense, a complete team victory.